So I found an Irish pub, the Dubliner. I've been there tonight. I'd probably been there last night if I realised how close it was to the hostel. Hostel was just over that way, over the opposite side of the road. I've had a fantastic night's sleep, absolutely wonderful. I got in at, I think it was about 4:30, I got checked in, got up to the room. I had to lay down and I fell asleep till 9. I then got up, I thought I had a shower. I thought, shall I go out? I decided against it, I was still tired. And it's Thursday, I'd had a full day at work and then a full travel night. Arrived in Oslo at 10 in the morning on Friday without really any. I did get a couple of hours sleep, an hour on the plane. It doesn't really count, didn't have much sleep. Wandered around the Opera House and the Munch Museum, so I was shattered. Yeah, so 9 o'clock, I got up, had a shower, made my bed up. Because in the hostel, you have to put your own sheets on. And went back to bed. The time's now 8:40. I've had some breakfast. It was a bit small in the hostel, but it was nice. Coffee, orange juice, and I think brie and bacon sandwich. I'm gonna find a lovely Oslo. It's lovely buildings, bit of a green space here, quite some old looking buildings over there, another cafe might have to check out. I was saying, yeah, I'm gonna find a 7-Eleven. They've got 7-Elevens here in Oslo, and get some snacks for the day. It's already warm. It's 8:41. The sun's out. Bit of cloud, but that looks like it'll clear. It's very warm. Lovely. Yes, I'm going to find a 7-Eleven, get some snacks for the ferry journey. I'm going to get the Ruta ferry, which is included in the one-day travel pass, which is about £9, I think, if my calculations are correct. And that allows you to use all the public transport in Zone 1 of Oslo. And the ferry that goes around the islands on Oslo Fjords included in that. So I'm going to take that option today. Alright then, 7-Eleven. Okay, I've got a 7-Eleven locked in. Direction, 6 minute walk. And it's going to take me along this green park here. Yeah, the buildings are lovely. Really impressed with Oslo, very clean. Reminds me in a way a bit like Dublin. Some of the buildings there are quite modern, mixed with the old brickwork. And yeah, very nice. Right, catch up the 7-Eleven, we'll pick up with some prices of local items. Like an old building over there, not sure what it is. We'll check it out later or another day. Paprika chips, 45. English.
You want light?
Okay, light.
That's all?
Say again?
That's all?
That's all, Ian.
171, please. You want a seat?
Oh, no, that's fine, thank you. Thank you very much. Well, so I was a 7-Eleven. I was expecting more of a convenience store. That was more like a breakfast. I was expecting like a normal convenience store. It was more coffee and breakfast. Anyway, I got some crisps, Spanish paprika, saw lamb's chips, Safari, Den Original, biscuits. Gosh, we've got a water, Capri Sun, and some Blair sweets. We'll try these, see what the Norwegian sweets are like. Everything seemed to cost about 45, 46. Well, they're alright. Like milk bottles. Save them for later. So I got a bag of crisps, some cookies, Capri Sun drink and some sweets, and that comes to 171 knock. That's £12.68, quite expensive. It's not as bad as I imagined, but still expensive. Next. Not sure if this is the town hall. Could be. There's lots of people around in traditional dress, but I don't know what they're doing. But it was a bit hard to photograph them. I thought it was a bit rude, to be honest. There's some boats down here. We're close to the Ruta ferry. You can get more expensive ferries. They're private, that do a bigger tour of the Oslo Fjord. But I'm not sure if they give you the option to get off at the islands or not. Whereas this one stops at all the islands. You can get off and have a walk around and catch later on back. She's been shit on. Birds would like to congregate here. This must be it here, B1, B2. It's two routes, B1 and B2. B1 goes to all the islands, B2 only a few of them, so we'll jump on the B1 route. I think that's right anyway, what I'm saying. I may be wrong. We're going to do the B1. I think. Or we'll go down the B1, B2. Just follow these guys, I think. I don't know which islands are better, which ones are, some are bigger than others. I'll just follow the crowd today. That's me on the B1 ferry. No idea where it's going to first. There's about four or five or six different islands, I think. And you can hop between them on the two different ferries, B1 and B2. Lovely weather today. Fjord's very calm. Looking forward to it. Got my snacks. Looking forward to having a walk around some of these little islands. Oh dear. That was a ferry ride to Hovedøya. I don't know how you pronounce it, if that's correct or not, let me know. Gonna have a walk around the island and see what it has to offer. Some kind of marina here. I don't know which way to go. So we've got toilets, that might be good for later. Most of the crowds are going, I don't know how that's a good thing or a bad thing. Boats here. I don't know if people live on the island or not. Beach, we'll head that way. People swimming in the marina in the fjord. I never thought to bring my swimming trunk. I've left them at the hostel. Anyway, I don't get and I've damp clothes with me and what have you, and damp towels, and I'll stick to walking today, I think. Yes, just having a steady stroll, taking the scenery. The islands are quite, this other island's quite close. Ferry's there, just going back out. So peaceful. Really, the weather really is lovely. I think it's about 18 degrees. And there's no wind whatsoever. It's so peaceful, it's perfect for walking. Yeah, there's a few other people around, but not many at all. It's very peaceful. Like I said, just taking my time. I don't think I've done the most economical route around this island. I wanted to do a circular, but I didn't see a map, and I think I'm going to end up kind of doing a figure of eight. I'm not too bothered. It's so nice. I'm just going to take my time. Probably do two or three islands, and then see if I've got time to go to the Fran Museum and the Contiki, which is a boat that I think some guy sailed around the world or a long way on a wooden raft, and they've got it there at the museum, so that'd be quite interesting. We'll see if I've got time for that. Old boat sailing by. Try and get a bit video on my phone of that. Some fenced off areas look like there's some rare plants. Don't know if it's an orchid, not sure what it is, but they must grow in this area. Keep my eyes out. Beautiful views, so warm. No English. Not sure what this building is. Lovely sand beach there, some got yellowy brown stuff in the water, which is a shame. I don't know what it is. I'm sure it looks quite natural, but it's off swimming a bit. Apart from that, beautiful. Well, it's back that way. Monastery ruin and ferry. Cannon battery. To the cannon battery. I hope that we can get away, get across to the monastery ruins from the cannon battery. Thank you. It's a Canon battery. They must have used this place as a defence years ago, I'm guessing. I'll see you over to the other islands from here. Beautiful. Looks like people live on that island over there. I don't think they do on this one. I'm not seeing any houses anyway. Right, so that's me at 2 miles. Really relaxing, peaceful little island walk that. Looking forward to the next island. I think there's houses on that one over there, so that'd be interesting to see some of the houses and how the people live on the island. I mean, it's not, it's only a couple of minutes away from the mainland, but so peaceful, tranquil. Really nice, no, very clean, not seeing one bit of litter. They've got bins and places for disposable barbecues to be disposed of. Really well organised, lovely. And the weather's superb, I keep saying it. Not sure what time the ferry comes, we're going to have a look now. 11 o'clock. Oien. No idea how you pronounce these. Langoyen. Here's the 8 and 8. So we've got 10 minutes to wait for that one to Oien. We'll be getting the B1 to Oien. I'll check on the map now. See whether that's that one over there or not. Catch on the boat.
Tack för uppmärksamheten. Vi önskar en hygglig och behaglig resa.
I'm du vad snickare.
Ja, men du
snart så glad du kom. Vi har en båt här borta.
Pappa, ni får in fishing.
Ja, vi ska visa skylt. Du bakom så här nu. Ja, det var bra.
Ja, var det.
Ja. Kör du, vi kan visa in här
bara. Ja, vi ska visa in här bara.
This is Lindoya Ost. Still no idea if I'm saying that right. But this island looks really interesting. It's inhabited. Houses look lovely. Exactly what you'd expect from Norway, Scandinavia. So looking forward to having a little look around this island. I don't know if I already said it, but I think the Zone 1 travel pass for Oslo is... it's about £10 for the day, 24 for 24 hours, and that includes these ferries, what I'm taking today around Oslo Fjord and all the, like I said, there's probably 5, 6, 7 islands you can go to. It's a regular service, it's all included in the Oslo City Pass, which is Zone 1, which is great value, I think, for the ferries. And you can also catch the metros, trams, buses, trains, whatever, as long as it's in Zone 1. Pretty good value, and seems very efficient. Very impressed. No idea which way to go here. Not a clue. To the left. Some locals look like having some stew or something. Private. Might be private tour around here. I'm gonna go back to where I've came, see if I can find another route. Beautiful though, really quaint. Garden Centre. Nice local shop. Feels weird filming around here, it's all people's houses, private. Beautiful. Look where I'm going, there's no signposts or anything. Everywhere's very well kept. Be another island over there. I thought that was the same one. Yeah, so I had to put the camera down there. There was someone sat in his garden. Very interesting island. I don't know if the holiday homes or people's main residence. Look probably a little bit small for main residence. I've done 1.18 miles and I didn't realise there's a ferry terminal on this side of the island, so I'm debating whether to get the ferry from here. Or walk back. Do another island, we'll go back to Oslo. 1, 2, 3, 4, so there's 6 islands that are linked. I think I've done enough, to be honest. I'm going to go back to Oslo, get something to eat, and then get the ferry from Oslo to, I think that'll be the B10. I believe here, I think this is where the Fram Museum is, in the Kon-Tiki. The boat, the little raft that sailed around the world, or sailed somewhere from Norway. So I'm going to go and see that, sounds interesting. I've got to go back to Oslo to get the ferry back. I'm just trying to work out. It's just 7 minutes past and 37. The time's 54, so there should be one coming soon. About 10 minutes. Good for that, I think. Go back to Oslo. Get something to eat, and then the Fram Museum. Really interesting little island, very quaint. All the properties are very well kept. There's people out mowing the lawns, cutting the hedges. It's nice weather for it. That's two of the islands visited on Oslo Fjord. First island I went to, I don't think anyone lived there, but it was strangely quite a big marina. This island, Lindøya, I'm not sure if that's the correct pronunciation, that's got a lot of houses on there. They're all quite small, so I don't know if they're second homes, holiday homes. There did seem to be a lot of people in them, making use of them. It is a weekend, I suppose, and it's beautiful weather, people cutting the hedges. Really quaint, really nice, kind of went. It's 10 past 12 now. So I think I caught the ferry about half nine, so half nine, half ten, half 11. So I've only been 2.5 hours, it feels like longer. It's been quite relaxing, really enjoyed it. Probably should have gone to another island, really. But anyway, I'll get back to Oslo, have something to eat. And then I'll get the ferry again to go to the Fram Museum, check that out. Just get lunch. The ferry to the Fram Museum was just coming in, so I jumped off one ferry straight onto the next. I'm not that hungry really, I can wait a little bit. If there's somewhere over this side of the water, I made it over here. See, lovely day still, beautiful weather. To say it gave out rain on the weather app, stunning. You are the Fram. It's like quite a small museum. I wonder if the boat's here. I'm sure the Fram's expedition ship being there. Another ship here. Norwegian flag flying. Nice trees here in bloom. A Here we have some kind of maritime statue. I can't read it, it's in Norwegian. Very interesting statue. It's like a sea mine, is it? Explosives. These are the sensors. Big old boat and Fram. Museum's on different levels, so you can walk around, see it from all angles. The V-shaped building, top of the masts, right at the top of the apex, just fits in. Expedition 1903 to 06, the first transit by ship through the Northwest Passage. Ronald Amundsen. There's a good jury. Just watched the entry to this video about the Fram and the good jury and some other expeditions. It's really interesting. Fascinating. It had a propeller, albeit a small one. Very surprised about that, unless that's a modern edition to move it. Bajora, first ship to sail in the Northwest Passage.
Oh, amazing. First petrol engine to be installed in a Norwegian vessel. Fascinating. And compared to the Gajora, the Fram is huge. And then they were designed for different types of expedition, I think. Amazing. Real explorers who went on these ships. Very dark in here. Well, someone stood there then. Pancakes. One thing on the Gajora, I didn't seem to see any living quarters. Seems a lot better fitted out. Thank you. Small birds. Clarky, how'd you fit on that?
Well, they must have been smaller back then.
Fascinating, a bit dark though. That was the Fram Museum behind me, really fascinating. Some real explorers of the times. I think the world was a bigger place then. Now I've got airplanes, you can get to any capital city within 24 hours really. Back then the expeditions lasted years. Amazing. Next up I'm going in the Kon-Tiki Museum. I don't know a lot about this one, but I think this one, they were ships. I think this guy sailed on a raft. I believe. I think, well, we'll see when I get in there. The greatest sea adventure of our time. Let's see. Looks like we went to Easter Island. This thing sailed from South America to French Polynesia, I believe, to show that it was possible in ancient civilization time by Norwegian. That was two fantastic museums, the Fram and the Contiki. But I thoroughly enjoyed both. I think found the Contiki one really fascinating too. So this guy wanted to prove that people from South America could cross to French Polynesia on a boat, and he made a boat out of balsa wood, a raft, sailed with a current, fantastic. And they built a reed boat from papyrus reeds and sailed it from Morocco to Barbados to show that ancient Egyptians could have travelled by sea to the Americas. And he thinks that the two cultures communicated as they both built pyramids around the same time, both worshipped the sun, both could write. They had similar things about the civilizations, and he thinks that they could have traveled across the sea. So tried to prove that theory, and he was successful on the Contiki. I think the Ra, I think that had some problems, and I think they had to be rescued, but they got to close to Barbados. So both fantastic museums, really worth a visit, and I timed it perfectly too, because when I came out of the Fram, it had been raining and the ground was soaked. It must have just stopped raining, and now the ground's pretty much dried up. It's warm again, so I missed the downpour. So I'm just going to get the boat back to Oslo City now. Maybe have a pint of Guinness in the Dubliner bar, see what their Guinness is like. And then head for my dinner. I'll call it a day after that. I've thoroughly enjoyed today. It's been fantastic.
So as per usual, I forgot to film a little outro last night after my dinner at Engebret Cafe. It's been going since 1800s. I just found it by chance actually. The day before I had my lunch there, seafood soup, which was delicious. That was a lunch menu and I thought this is fantastic, I'll come back for the evening menu and that was even better. The eel and smoked whale starter. Now the whale, it was just like smoked salmon really, but much richer. Now I've had whale before in Iceland and that was more like a steak. So whether it's a different cut or a different type of whale, I'm not sure, I should have asked really. But it was absolutely delicious. And the sauce on there, the accompaniment were fantastic. And then I had a reindeer steak from a main. And you got quite a lot of meat again. It was delicious. It was different to deer, to venison. But yeah, it was lovely. So really spoiled myself, and then I had like a caramel, like a creme brulee caramel dessert. That was fantastic as well, and a glass of wine. It's quite expensive. It all came to about £86. It is quite expensive here in Oslo. I thought I'd treat myself, and the wine, that was about £15 for one glass. So when I looked at it, I thought it was for the bottle, so I said, can I have a bottle? And then I realised, as I said, can I have a bottle, it was for a glass. I thought, better just have a glass, otherwise it would have been extremely expensive. So yeah, that was that. Lovely day out on the Oslo Fjord, highly recommend getting out there. Very relaxing. Yeah, lovely day. Thanks for watching.